The 40 Hadith of Imam Nawawi. Commentary by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Yaqubi.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise belongs to Allah Almighty. Best prayers and most fragrant salutations be upon the best of mankind, the seal of all prophets, the one who was sent but as mercy to the worlds, our master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are going in these series of talks to present the 40 hadith of al-Imam an-Nawawi. Imam Nawawi authored a collection of 40 hadith that became essential in the study of the deen. He compiled the most important hadith on which and around which the religion is based. In every short talk, we'll try to shed some light briefly and as briefly as possible in order to understand the tradition of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The first hadith is known as the hadith of intention. It starts with innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat. This is on the authority of Sayyiduna Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه. إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته إلى دنيا يصيبها أو امرأة ينكحها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. This hadith is agreed upon between Al-Bukhari and Muslim. This hadith is supposed to have quarter of our religion based on it. This hadith is source of blessings. This is why Al-Imam An-Nawawi started his collection with it. He also started the collection of Riyad al-Salihin, the gardens of the righteous, with this hadith, and started his other book, Al-Adhkar, the invocations, with the same book. Not only that, but before him, Al-Imam al-Bukhari himself started his Sahih with this beautiful hadith about intention, about sincerity, about doing things for the sake of Allah alone, not for the sake of anyone else. إنما الأعمال بالنيات. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam confines here that actions are rewarded only when there is a good intention. Actions are considered to be valid only when there is good intention. This intention must be for the sake of Allah, must be to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Him, to obey Him. إنما الأعمال, إنما only, confined, actions are confined in their rewards only when they are preceded by intentions. إنما الأعمال بالنيات. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam succinctly put it in these very few words. It's a catchphrase. It is like a cliche. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. This is an example of the eloquence, of the most eloquent human being, especially amongst Arabs in the Arabic language, Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. He continues, وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى. Every person gets the rewards or the harvest or the fruits of his intention. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continues, anyone who migrates or whose migration is done for the sake of Allah, it'll be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And anyone whose intention was for some worldly matters or to marry a certain woman, his intention is confined only in the goals which he set for himself. So we see here that we need to purify our intentions. We need to make sure that what we're doing, we're not doing it in order to become famous, or we're not worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that people see us and talk nicely about us, praise us. No, we're doing these things only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray. Our prayer is valid only when we make intention for it. Now, this is very obvious because the ibadah is not valid without an intention. But what about worldly matters? We eat. That's a necessity. We have 3 meals every day or 2 meals or even 1 meal. This is something worldly, but we must have an intention for it. What intention? Eating is to feed yourself. Sometimes it is a pleasure. But you can't maintain life without eating and drinking. Now, you can make this an act of worship and get rewards for it by intending to become stronger in order to continue worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you're weak, you won't be able to stand up in the nights or stand up even during the day to continue performing your prayers. You see here, you get married. It's a pleasure, but make the intention that you protect your chastity. You establish the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And you bring an offspring of Muslims that makes mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worship Allah. You visit your friend. You love him. You want to visit him and see him. Make a good intention that you meet together in order to remind each other of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So why not re-look and reconsider your actions based on this statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, actions are rewarded only by their intentions. Actions are considered perfect only according to their intention. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. Do whatever you want. According to the intention that you have, you will be rewarded accordingly. May Allah bless you. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.